Hello everybody and welcome on my YouTube channel. You are with Alandris and today I'm on the test server to try for you one of the new heroes who will be available next month. It will be probably an event hero. It's an agility hero. It's Blade.
The glory of the assassin shall illuminate this world.
So we will begin to see how the hero looks like. So it's a kind of ninja, you can see it in the pictures. About the animations, this is the victory animation, movement animation, and we can also have normal attack animation. So, what the game is telling about this hero, frontline agile hero who can damage enemies with his blade. So it's an agility hero like I told in the introduction. And we will check his statistics now on the website HCharge.tk. So I will just compare two different statistics. First one, statistics that he has at level 107, red 4 with 4 items, and the statistics that he will have when he will be level 110. So you can see that at level 107, he will have something like 108,000 HP, 13,390 of physical attack, 1,080 of armor, 461 of magical resistance, and a big score of critique, 2,623. Also, one interesting score to watch is the lifesteal, 150. And if we are checking the level 110, he will get for sure the most strong item. For most of players, it will be at least in 1 year. So he will get something like 13,000 HP more, 2,000 more of physical attack, 107 of armor, the same magical resistance more or less, 300 physical critical score more, and 60 lifesteal rating more. So it's some really interesting statistic. I don't know how he will be, I still didn't test him. And what I want to tell, this statistic are for the hero's full train. It's not a statistic without training. So let's now discover his skills. So let's discover the skills of Blade together. The ultimate skill, Bladed Cloak. Whistler spins his bladed cloak, damages enemies ahead and throws them into the air. So some damage, I think, for all enemies in front of him, and also a knockback. So we will see how much damage it's dealing, but look like not bad. The green skill, Bladed Strike. Whistler strikes enemies in a sector area and reduces their armor, increases 3850 damage and reduce armor by 275. Sort of damage plus debuff, it's not bad at all, but we need to see in which area it will touch enemies. Blue skill, Bladed Vortex. Whistler summons multiple blades around him, dealing damage to enemies nearby. Doesn't look like amazing, 2200 damage, but perhaps we will have some good surprise during the test. And finally, the purple skill, defense mod. Whistler activates his defense mod, reducing incoming damage and restoring HP. HP recovery 8800 every second, plus the reducing of incoming damage that we don't know how much it will reduce. But it's an interesting skill because don't forget that Blade is an agility hero in front lane. So even if in according of his statistic, it doesn't look like so much squishy, it's interesting to know how he will survive and to have something to help him to survive. So now we will check his position on the battlefield and after this we will do the skill test. Usually when we have some agility frontliners, they are behind the tank. I hope that it will be like that. So okay, we can be already happy. Most of heroes will be in front of him. For the moment, all heroes are in front of him. Even Ah, Finslayer is behind. We found one who is behind. Ok, for others is normal. All real tanks are in front of him and nearly all heroes in the game are in front of him. So, it's a good news because like I told, it's an agility hero. And, oh, I removed him. Sorry. And usually when you have agility hero, it's important to keep them behind tanks. Okay. Ah, you see that Griffin is behind. Yes, Griffin is behind. It's an interesting information. And finally, I think it will be only Finslayer and Griffin who will be behind him. Okay, and last one. Ah, perhaps, no. Not nothing, sorry. Okay, so only Finslayer and Griffin in who are behind him. It's interesting for Griffin. For Finslayer, it doesn't matter actually. So it's time now to check how his skills are working. So it will be interesting to see how his skills are working. So the green skill. Oh, green skill is touching frontline and backline. So it's really interesting. The blue skill, so the blue skill, like I was thinking, is not really amazing by damage. This is the ultimate. Okay, we'll accelerate a little bit the fight. Green skill, blue skill. I think purple skill is passive. It's a passive skill because I didn't see him activate his skill, but look, we can see that he has an important regeneration. So I think that the purple skill is passive. It's really good. And finally, how much damage he dealt. Statistic. Oh, 518,000 damage in a little match with only two heroes. We can have some interesting expectation about this hero. Let's begin by the damage test. So, for this damage test, we will see what he's able to do. Or she, perhaps Blade, it's a woman. When I see the eyes of the hero, I'm not sure that it's a man. So we will see, it doesn't matter, but it matters. Ah, I can check by the symbol if it's a man or a woman. Okay, the ultimate. We will accelerate the fight a little bit. For the moment, I'm really happy about what I see. Nothing broken, but some interesting skills. Debuff of armor, some knockback. Only the blue skill is really, really not amazing, but the rest of skills are really interesting and well designed. And even the blue skill is not stupid because she's doing one pack with her ultimate. And finally, she will touch a lot of heroes with her blue skill, but damage are not crazy. And you see 523,000. It's not bad because we are against an healing team with a lot of skill animations. That's why we lost sometimes. But definitively, it's a good damage dealer and we will see it in real situation right now. During this first fight, we will learn some interesting things. First point, Blade is a man, definitively. I just checked in the description of the hero and it's a man. Second point, I'm fighting against a standard Turtle Fighter setup that we can meet. I'm using basically some setup who is working really good plus Blade. And last point, really important, you will see that the purple skill of Blade is finally not a passive like I was thinking in the beginning, but it's an activate skill that probably Blade activate when he is low life. It's now. You see the shield around him and it's the fourth skill. About damage now, 215, so like Thunder Beast and Sorceress in a short fight, with burst, with some direction who changed during the match. So I think really it's interesting, and we will see now in some other situations. In this situation, we are facing a physical setup with only Bloody Earl, who is not physical. And in our team, I choose to put a physical setup also to get benefit of the armor debuff of a blade. So, we will see finally the result of the match. Arcane Sapper is dead, Bloody Earl is dead, and you can see that Blade is nearly all the time full of life because of his life regeneration, who is just crazy. Even with Divine Knight in front, who normally cancels the life regeneration, he doesn't have any problem. And finally, we will win this match, even without activate the purple skill. And we can see the statistic, best damage dealer of the team, 260, so it's really interesting. And an important point, don't forget that we can't see it, but it's also some additional damage who are coming from him due to his armor debuff when you have a physical setup. So, let's check now a last situation. For this last fight, I'm fighting against a team with a lot of control. You have Rabbit, you have Voidmaster behind, you have the Dragon for sure. And look carefully on Blade. He will activate his skill for regeneration right after this. Now, and look now that the skill is activated, the regeneration of a life. He's in the poison and he's not losing any life. And finally, he will be nearly full of life at the end of the fight. So we'll see the detail. 255, so not bad. You can see that it's nearly the top damage dealer. In this fight, we didn't have so much physical damage dealer, so it's no additional damage. But it's interesting, lot of control, lot of survivability. And a lot of regeneration. You can see it's in survivability, but it's always amazing to see the life with growing up, growing up, growing up by 10% nearly every second. So that's all for the fights. It's now time to speak about his strengths and weaknesses. Some important points for Blade as strength. First point is damage output is pretty interesting. You saw during the fight that it's always one of the top damage dealer. Second point, he has a great survivability due to his lifesteal, but due also to his pool of HP and his armor. So, another good point. And finally, he's able to add some damages that we can't see directly with his debuff, because with his green skill you reduce the armor by 275. It's not bad, because if it's a tank, for sure it will be really low, but if it's a normal hero, it can remove 33% of his armor value. So it's pretty interesting. Let's now discover his weaknesses. 2 points as weaknesses for Blade, in my opinion. The first point, it's that the main skill, the green skill, Bladed Strike, who is dealing a lot of damage and reducing the target's armor by 275, it's a directional skill. So, if you have a Sapper, will go behind you, if you have Turtle, if you have some other heroes like that, you will touch only 1-2 heroes and you will lose a lot of efficiency of this hero. It's the first point. And the second point, this hero has a good damage output, like I told in the strength, but he doesn't have a burst. His ultimate, it's not bad, he's dealing some damage, it's true, and it's a good damage dealer for sure, but it's not a nuker who can kill one target really quickly. So it's a weakness, even if it's not a catastrophe, for sure. So, we will speak now about my final evaluation about this hero. Finally, for me, Blade will be a really interesting event hero. It's a hero with well balanced, in my opinion. Perhaps it should be good if they little bit increase the blue skill, who is not amazing actually, but we have a balance between survivability and damage with interesting. It's not a hero who is able to burst like I explained, but you have one hero who will be long time during a long time on the battlefield, who will stun, who will remove the armor, who will pack enemies in one direction with his ultimate, and who is also able to receive some damage. So it's an agility hero, but who can hold like a tank. Be careful, like a tank, not a long time. But during the activation of his purple skill, he's able to hold like a tank. So finally, if you have some money and if you want to invest on him during the event, it's a real possibility. And it's not a waste of money because this hero is definitely suitable in Grand Arena, Grand Tournament, War of the God, and Championship. So, it's all for today with Blade. It's now time to conclude. Thank you everybody for watching this video. Don't hesitate to subscribe, like, and share to support my work if you enjoy it. See you soon for another video. Bye bye.